A unique invoice number is essential, not just a formality. It's crucial for keeping your record straight, ensuring you get paid on time, and avoiding any mix-ups with clients. Having a structure to your invoice can also help with tracking your invoices, identifying specific transactions, and handling your VAT returns. I'm going to start simple and make it more complex, including client information and dates. By the end of this tutorial, you'll be comfortable creating a unique invoice number that includes all of the elements that work best for you. A super quick recap, I have my invoice information here, which is linked to my invoice here. Control P for print preview. Let's create some invoice numbers. Start from scratch. Each row is uniquely defined by its row number. To create a unique invoice, we can just use the row number. Formula is row. Select any cell on the same row. Drag that down, double click here. Now you've got unique invoice numbers, but it's not easy to tell it's an invoice number. So why don't we add something at the beginning that says this is an invoice number? We can add anything we like to the beginning. I often use INV, make sure you put it in speech marks. And then you can put an and symbol and drag that down. The alternative to the and symbol is using concatenate and separating with a comma. Same result. There's no real benefit apart from sounding clever, and I just like the word concatenate. But the disadvantage is a lot more keystrokes. So let's go back to the and symbol, and we can always say ampersand to still sound clever. Control Z to undo the last few steps. Next, I don't like the fact that the invoice numbers have a different length. I want a consistent number of digits. So what we're going to do now is add some leading zeros. We use this using the text function, which lets us tell Google what format we want. So we can use text, what we want formatted, then in speech marks the format. So I want to have 4 or 5 zeros. Now we'll always have unique invoice numbers up to 9,999. Within this text function, we can even actually put the INV dash and start with a different digit if we want to. So it sounds like we've got a lot more invoices and we're a lot more experienced than we really are. There you go. I don't have many clients, I just have a few big clients. So I add the client's initials and the date to the invoice number. The date makes it easier for when I'm doing my VAT returns. I know which months are in that quarter, and the client initials mean I instantly know who's paid me, and I do love a quick payer. So let's get the client's name first. Here's our client names. I'm just going to take the first letter, and just for ease, I'm going to take the last letter for now. So to take the first letter, we start from the left and we use the function left. We tell it company name and how many digits we want. We only want one digit. Just to make it easier for now, I'm going to take the last letter. So moving in from the right, we're going to use and again and then right. Select the company name and one digit again. To put this in capital letters, use the uppercase function upper. Next on this invoice, I'm going to add the date. Use my and again. Use that function text that we saw earlier. This time we're going to take the date, which is cell B2. And the format, we can use date formats. With a date format, YY is year, MM month, DD date. And this means that they're just two digits. So two digits for the year, the month, and the date. There you go, years 2024, fifth month is May, 25th day. You can add a hyphen if you want to separate them. You can also add things like slashes. And if you want the full year, you do 4 Ys. And if you want the month written, 3 letters, it's 3 Ms. Let me drag that down so you can see that it's always 3 letters. So June is 3 letters. And if you want the full month written out, you can do 4 letters. However, I prefer mine to be almost like a secret hidden code. I'm going to go back to what we had before, which is just YYMMDD with a little dash. Now we're going to go back so it's actually initials rather than the first letter and last letter. As you can see, ink has got a dot at the end, so this gives us a bit of a weird invoice number. So instead of using right, we're not going from the left or the right, we want a letter that's in the middle. The function is called mid. Mid needs a bit more information than right, which just needed the string and the number of characters. Mid needs the string, the starting position, and the number of characters. The string is still the company name, and it's going to be 1 character long. The moment it's starting from the first letter, but actually it needs to start from just after the space. That space is always at a different place, so we need to find the space. So we're going to replace this one with find. We need to tell it
that it's looking for a space.
Where it's looking at. Looking at D2 again. Here it's found the space, but actually we want the letter after the space. So this is finding the space, then add one, so it goes along one.
I'm going to add the row number in the background. You can mix and match how it suits you. For example, using date and row number or customer number and row number. You probably won't want it more complicated than name, date, row number.
Now we want to make sure that we can select the invoices in here. Let me take away this data validation and start again. So to do the data validation, we go to data, data validation, add rule,
drop down from a range, click here, equals, go to your database. Sometimes you have to click somewhere else first. Select the whole of column A.
Advanced options. Let's have an arrow. Done. Now you can select your invoices. Scroll all the way to the bottom for your last one and everything else updates automatically. The other thing that you might want to do is tell people to use your invoice number when they are paying. At the bottom, after you've got your payment details, you can put in equals
something like,
we're making payment, please use the reference number, space, and then put in the invoice number here so that this always change. We can make this a little bit longer so you can see it because we've got a long invoice number now. So when we've got QB, Queen Bee Creations, this will give them the invoice number that we use, which makes it easier when we're reconciling our accounts. That's it for today's tutorial. Hope you found it useful. If you did, subscribe for more tips on automating that admin. Let me know what you want help with next, and maybe watch another video that is now being suggested.